sa lahat. Isa pong malakas na palakpak para sa mga ito. Many of you are blessed with our worship time to our songs. Hindi yung pag-isang mas malakas na palakpak pa rin. Lord, we come before you right now, grateful and thankful for all the things that you have done in our lives, and to be able to worship you with our voices, with our lives, with all our ourselves. Is indeed a privilege. And so I help us continue to dwell in your presence with an attitude of thanksgiving, with a desire to know you and exalt you. And we ask that you speak to us as our loving Father. And we are children. As we love your word, and we love to hear you, our Father. We commit in this time that there be joy as we study your word right now. We praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let me start our study this afternoon by telling you a story of a said to be three persons in heaven who have decided to one day play a round ball at the Heavenly Court, Country Club. May God give you para sa langit. To yung istorya. The first man stepped up to the tee and hit his drive and watched as it headed the ball heading to the water. Papunta po yung bola doon sa water. But while the ball going on the water, this guy raised up his hand together with the club as if he gave a sign. And suddenly, the water was separated and the ball fell to the ground. And this guy went between the water and hit the ball, and lo and behold, he had an exact hit that it went to the hole. The other guy said, amazing. So the next man, again, went to the tee and hit the ball, and it went on the same path which the first man had, okay, going into the water. But this time, when the ball was about to hit the water, it started to stay above the water. And so the next person from that heaven went to the ball and hit once more the ball, and again it was an exact hit going to the hole. And then the first guy, who happens to be Moses, said, what a pretty, pretty hit that you had, Jesus. And so the third person again went to the tee and hit the ball. But this time the ball went to the other side, into the forest, in the trees. And seemingly it's out of bounds. But while the ball was going around, suddenly there was a squirrel who thought that the ball was a nice food to eat. So the squirrel took the ball and went running on the fairway. Suddenly, there was an eagle who snatched the squirrel and flew together with the squirrel and the ball. But while flying, this eagle was, when he was already in the meadows of the green, lost the squirrel together with the ball. So, bumagsak yung bola. And while the ball was bouncing twice, then it went to the hole. A perfect hit. And then Moses looked at the Lord Jesus Christ and said, "This is why I don't want to play God with your dad." I don't know if you did catch the story. Amazing things happens in heaven. And almost all people have been in one way or another to experience an extraordinary life. Lahat daw halos ang tao ay nakakaranas ng pangarap na minsan siya makaranas ng kakaibang karanasan sa buhay. An extraordinary life. Good news, brethren, anyone under the kingdom of God and His authority is capable of experiencing such exceptional living. Meron po tayong kakayanang maranasan ang kakaibang buhay kapag tayo kabahagi ng karya ng Diyos. That's why this afternoon we're going to talk about exceptional kingdom living as part of our theme, Foundations in the Kingdom of God. And I entitled God's message this afternoon as Living Above the Level of Mediocrity. Living Above the Level of Mediocrity. Mediocrity, in a simple definition, it says it is the ordinary life, average life. So how can we rise and live above the level of an ordinary life? Let's hear passage this afternoon, and we'll be reading from Numbers chapter 14, verses 1 to 9. Numbers 14, 1 to 9. I have been requesting once more that everyone will please rise. We'll be reading 2 verses each. And the people on my left will be reading the first 2 verses, and then we'll start in the next slide with another 2 verses. Alright? Numbers 14, 1 to 9. Ready? Begin. Of those people who are able to live exceptionally and above the level of mediocrity, above the average for ordinary life. What are their traits? Let me give you the first one. And this is a cover, actually. First, people who live above the levels of mediocrity has a foresight and focus. A foresight and focus. Alright? Pag-isabi nga po natin, foresight and focus. Let me again introduce our passage. When God started to build His kingdom through the nation of Israel, gusto ko po ipakita sa atin, even before God is already building His kingdom. Okay? And He's doing it through the nation of Israel. It was His plan to make them a peculiar and exceptional nation against all other nations around them. Gusto ng Panginoon na itanghal sila na kakaibang bansa, kaibang bayan o mga grupo ng tao. In fact, at the time that God was making covenant in this particular nation, in the nation of Israel, kung saan familiar tayo doon sa pinanggalingan ng sampung utos ng Diyos in Exodus chapter 19, we'll find these verses that will tell us that God was really in the business of making Israel as a nation, as a kingdom that He called for Himself. As sabi po dito sa... If you have your Bible, you can look the passage Exodus 19, 4-6. Right? It says there, "You yourselves have seen what I did to Egypt," God was speaking to the nation of Israel, "and how I carried you on eagle's wings. I brought you to myself. Now, if you obey me fully and keep my covenant, then out of all nations you will be my treasured possessions. Although the whole nation or the whole earth is mine, you will be for me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation." Mula doon sa talata na ito, mga kapatid, ay pinapakita ng Diyos that Israel was really a chosen nation. Itatanghal niya ang bansang ito na as an outstanding nation and a group of exceptional people. Sila yung bansa na pinili niya upang ipahayag ang kanyang kaluwatian at ang pagtatayo ng kanyang kaharian. So, that's why the Ten Commandments was not actually a means to salvation. Let me reiterate that. Following the Ten Commandments is not a means to salvation. It was a confirmation of a relationship between the nation of Israel and God. There was already a relationship between God and Israel. Mayroon na ugnayan, mga kapatid. In fact, scholars of the Bible will tell you that what happened in Mount Sinai was actually a wedding between God and the nation of Israel. Sa totoo lang, ang imagery na pinapakita doon sa bundok ng Sinai, ano po, ay it's an image of wedding where God is being wedded to the bride, the nation of Israel. Kaya nga merong covenant, merong pirmaan na nangyari. And they were given the Ten Commandments not for them to be saved, but there was already an agreement that they entered into, which is known to us as a covenant. Okay, may sumpaan na sila. Kaya doon po sa bundok ng Sinai nangyari yung kasalan ng ating Diyos at ng bayan ng Israel. Because God declared that they will be His treasured possession. Diba? Lagi ko po sinasabi, kapag pinapaliwanag po talaga ko, para siyang lalaki na nanunuyo sa isang babae na sinasabing, "Ikaw lang ang kayamanan ko." Sarap kong pakinggan niya sa mga babae, no? God is saying that to the nation of Israel, "You will be my treasured possession. I have carried you on my eagle's wings." Okay? "And you will be a kingdom of priests and a holy nation." Now, kinasalo sila doon sa Sinai. Unfortunately, they're still parang bagong kasal, wala pa mong permanenteng matutuluyan. So they were still wandering in the desert. Ano po? Temporarily, they were being sheltered. Pero maganda, hindi sila pinababayaan ng kanyang ng kanilang Diyos. Okay? Sa umaga, ay merong ulap na kasama at sa gabi ay may apoy na nagbabantay sa kanila at nagpapakitang kasama nila ang Diyos. Now, it came to that point na medyo siguro nakaipon-ipon na rin ng konti ang Diyos. God was able to save. And now He would like to present with the nation of Israel a permanent residence. Ititira niya na doon sa bahay na inanda niya. Saan bahay yun? It is called as the Promised Land. The Promised Land. It is the land that was promised for this nation to be a dwelling place, a symbol of prosperity, a symbol of God's love to the nation of Israel. And our passage that we have read speaks about the nation of Israel having a glimpse of what the Promised Land is. Pinapakita ngayon ng Diyos kung ano yung Promised Land na yon. Ang sabi niya, in chapter 13, 4 passages, "Send 12 spies into that land. Get one person from each tribe. And look at the Promised Land." Ano meron doon? Sino nakatira doon? So they spent 12 persons doon sa Promised Land. And they saw that the promised land was really a land flowing with milk and honey. It was a literal prosperous place for them. It was an exceptional place for exceptional people like them. Kaya nga po napakaganda na pinapakita rito ng Diyos sa bayan ng Israel para patunayan gano'n niya kamahal ang bayan ito. And so, after the 12 spy out the land, pagkatapos nila makita yung lupa, gano'n sila katanggal na lumibot doon sa lupain, 40 days. Again, that's a symbol that is special for God. 40 days. And for 40 days, they saw the goodness of that land. Then they went back to Moses and gave the report. And the report is that they disclose, or the report disclosed that Joshua and Caleb are the guys who live above the levels of mediocrity against the other 10 spies because they have a foresight of God's will. You know why? When the 12 returned, the other 10 reported, "We cannot conquer it." Meron kami nakita mga tao doon. Marami po kasing naninirahan na doon sa lugar na pinapupunta sa kanila ng Panginoon. There's the Jebusites, the Anakites, the Canaanites, and the Nephilim. It happens to be the lineage of Goliath. Na kung saan ay mga higante yung mga tao. That's why natakot po sila. But there's two among the 12 who stood up and rose above the level of all those ordinary people and says, "We can do it." And they were saying this passage, "If the Lord is pleased with us, He will lead us into that land, a land flowing with milk and honey, and will be given to us." Pinapakita rito mga kapatid, labindalawa silang nag-report, but only two was able to pursue and to continue and keep on looking at the foresight or the vision that God was giving them. A land flowing with milk and honey. Nakita nila na merong pangarap ang Diyos para sa kanila. Ito yung pangarap ng Diyos para sa kanila. Unfortunately, the 10 happens to lose the foresight. Napakalaga po sapagkat ang tao na nakakaangat sa isang ordinaryong buhay, kadalasan ay mga tao may pangarap at merong pangitain sa kanyang buhay. Amen po ba? People who has a foresight, goals or dreams are people who can live extraordinarily and can live above the levels of mediocrity. Not just like these two persons. Napakalaga na sino mang taong magsasabi gusto niya umangat sa kanyang buhay, ang unang tumutulong sa kanya sa na attitude na meron siya, particularly, ay yung kanyang pangarap sa buhay. At ginagamit po yan ng Panginoon. Because it is really important that for us to be able to rise and pursue what God has intended for us, there should be a direction or purpose. It was Rick Warren who said that the greatest tragedy in life is not death, but life without a purpose, life without a direction. Ang pinakamalaking trahedya sa ibabaw ng lupa ay hindi yung kamatayan, mga kapatid. Ang pinakamalaking trahedya sa ibabaw ng lupa ay yung buhay na walang direksyon. Buhay na nasasayang sapagkat walang pangarap. When these people were confronted, only Joshua and Caleb stood declaring their focus or foresight on the goal of being in the promised land. Now, Joshua and Caleb not only had a foresight, but they didn't lose their focus on the foresight. Pwede may pangarap ka eh. Maraming ang tao may pangarap. But along the way, they lose the focus on the foresight, on the vision. Marami pong ganyan mga kapatid. Marami nang angarap pero hindi naabot because instead of pursuing yung walang pangarap, they lose the focus. Ha? Pangarap mong umasenso. Pero bigla na lang may dumaan sa harapan mong napakagandang bilan. Napakagwa kong binata. At nakita mo na parang hindi mo maating na siya ay hindi mapasayo. At hahamakin mo ang lahat. Diba?
So what happened? You lose the focus. We lose the focus. This guy lost the focus because it was clear to them that the vision was for them to enter the promised land. All of the 12 spies saw the promised land, but the 10 spies got distracted by the threat of the occupants in the territory. That's why they lose their focus. They were distracted. Nakita nila yung malalaking tao na naroon, yung maraming tao na nasa loob ng promised land. Natakot na sila and they lose the focus. Itong problema mga kapatid, marami naman talagang tao may pangarap. Halos lahat ng tao may pangarap. Pero yung aabutin mo na yung pangarap, when you try to reach for that goal, for that dream, and you see the obstacles and the hardship, now you begin to focus on the obstacles, on the hardships. Because at the onset, we thought na basta may pangarap ka, magtatagumpay ka. Hindi po. Meron kasabihan, vision without action is hallucination. You may have a vision, but without that action, without that focus to pursue the vision, you will end up still defeated. Madalas, marami pong tao, they lose the focus. They have the vision. They have a desire. These people knew that it is God's plan for them to enter the promised land, but they lost the focus. Natakot sila eh. Okay? Kaya yun ang problema sa maraming tao, mga kapatid. Ang ganda ng pangarap, but suddenly along the way, pag merong distraction, nawawala tayo sa focus. There were two guys, two friends, who watched the Kenny G concert. Okay? The great saxophonist. Yung ba? Napakagaling. And so after watching the concert, the other friend actually, the other guy, said it was awesome. Napakaganda ng concert. And he asked his friend, how about you? How did you see? Sabi ng kaibigan niya. You see, when I saw him, how his nose got bigger when he blew the saxophone, it destroyed my whole evening. Hey, imagine, ang ganda po siya ito, pero dahil nakita niya, lumalaki yung ilong ni Kenny Gisipay, nakapokus siya doon sa ilong. Distracted. Naging nakapokus siya doon sa hindi mas malaga. Sapagkat, samantala, ganda ng music. People, we are always distracted by many things. You came here to work. But there are a lot of distractions along the way. And sometimes, before you know it, you are already outside of the path that you're taking. So mark this trait of a person who can rise above the level of mediocrity. They have a foresight, but they have also the focus. Pakisabi po natin, focus. Pakisabi mo, mag-focus ka. Mag-focus ka. The second thing that we'll be learning from people who live above the levels of mediocrity is that they are fearless because of faith in God. They are fearless because of faith in God. Again, the 10 spies were telling the truth. The land is wonderful. Nung mag-report yung mga spies, sabi nila, talaga nang pag binasa niyo yung chapter 13 prior to this 14, they were reporting at the onset, ang ganda ng lugar. It was literally a land flowing with milk and honey. In fact, what they did, they took some specimen. Alam niyo yung specimen mga kapatid? They took some fruits of the grape tree. Okay? At kumuha lang sila ng isang branch na meron isang cluster. You know how many people carried that? Two persons. Nilagay nila sa likuran nila. Para merong kahoy, para bang meron dala-dala. Gaano kalaki yung bunga ng grapes na yun? Isang branch lang po yung mga kapatid. Of course, there's pomegranate, there's figs. Two person has to carry the fruit from the land. It was really a land that is fruitful. and then flowing with milk and honey. Kaya nga po, namakita ito, ang ganda ng report nila. Unfortunately, again, when they saw also the people who are residing and dwelling in that land, they remembered how fearful, nakakatakot yung mga tao. They remembered the Egyptians had been trying for years to take over this area, the promised land. But they were unsuccessful. And if the Egyptians was powerful by that time, one of the greatest armies they have, eh hindi unang tagumpay. How could a group of untrained former slaves, kasi galing sila sa Egypt, mga slaves sila. Inisip nila, paano kami magtatagumpay? Eh yung basang sumako sa amin, o nakasako sa amin, hindi kinaya ito. Kaya nga, natakot sila mga kapatid. It really caused them tremendous fear. But note that Caleb did not discount what the other 10 say. Hindi niya nireject yung sinasabi ng 10 na talaga ng maganda eh. Kinilala na rin na may mga taong nakatira doon, mga higante. Right? They did not say that what the other 10 is not true. Because the fact or facts are facts. Yung katotohanan, hindi pwedeng maguhin. But Caleb just see things differently. He sees things from a different perspective, from the perspective of faith in God. Itong kaiba nila mga kapatid, yung 10 nakita nila, yung nasa harap nila. Pero hindi nila nakita yung nakikita ni Joshua at ni Caleb. Yung mas malaki kaysa doon sa mga higante, yung Diyos. Kaya nga in verse 9, sabi po ni Joshua at Caleb, do not be afraid of the people of the land because we will swallow them up. Can you imagine the description of Joshua and Caleb? Lulunukin lang natin sila. Their protection is gone, but the Lord is with us. The Lord is with us. Malalaki sila, pero kasama natin ang Diyos. This was actually what they declared to Moses. And it's true, mga kapatid. Many, many times when we're confronted with hardships, with terminal sickness, incurable for many doctors, somehow we lose hope. Wag po. Doctors are still people. There's a being that is bigger than those doctors. We have God. We have God. At ang maganda, sabi ni Joshua Caleb, the Lord is with us. Pansin niyo po yung promise na dinigleyan ni Joshua at ni Caleb, the Lord is with us. Hindi po sinabi ni Joshua na mawawala yung mga hadlang na yun. But the Lord is with us. Kaya kung taliwas yung mga sinasabi ng maraming tao na yun, yung mga nagtuturo, that when you become a Christian, mawawala lahat ng problema mo. Again, baliktad po yan mga kapatid, pag naging Kristiyano ka, mas marami pa nga ang problema eh. Natuklasan nyo na ba? Pakitan mo sa katabi, natuklasan mo na kapatid. Nung maging Kristiyano ka, mas marami problema. That is, simple-simple lang buhay mo eh. Di ba? Simple-simple lang buhay mo eh. But when you became a Christian, suddenly, dumami. Hindi masama yun. Why? Because this time, before, you are just citizen of the kingdom of Satan. This time, you were transferred to the citizen of being citizen of the kingdom of God. At ngayon, meron ka ng kapangyarihan para gamitin ng Panginoon na umabot na ibang tao at maging pagpapala sa kanila. Kaya mas malaki problema. But the promise is this, in spite of the hugeness of the problem, in spite of the greatness of the obstacle, the Lord will not leave us. The Lord will be upon us. He will be with us. Ito yung promise mga kapatid. Gaano man kahirap yung dinadaanan natin, hindi tayo iiwan ng Panginoon. Amen po ba?
Amen.
God will never leave us. The Lord is with us. Kasama natin ang Diyos. Nasabi mo nung isang bata eh. As long as there's someone in the sky who protects me, there's no one on earth who could break me. Sarap po, no? Bata mo yan. Kaya minsan kinakailangan natin maging bata sa Diyos.
Mga kapatid, we need just to exercise our faith in God. Sometimes, kulang lang sa exercise. Di ba? And sometimes, God has to give us hardships in life so that we can exercise our faith. Because mas madalas natin exercise yung katawan natin. Pa-tennis-tennis dyan. Pa-basketball-basketball. Pero how about our faith? You can only be exercising your faith if there's something that is hard and seemingly impossible that you are confronted with. Na-exercise mo lang yan pag mayroong isang bagay na hindi mo kaya at Diyos lang ang may kayang gawin. Kasi pag kaya mong gawin, chances are, you'll not trust God. You don't need God. Kaya mo eh. Pero pag hindi mo kaya, then you will look for somebody who's greater than you. And you start trusting that greater being who is God. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to exercise our faith. When was the last time you had an exercise of your faith? Ako, kamakailan lang, meron ng exercise no faith. I tried to apply my daughter's visa, transferring it from business visa to residence visa because it's expiring this last day of August. When I went to the immigration, I was confronted immediately, of course, of the people who attended to me, who happens to be a local. And immediately, he was looking for attested birth certificate, which happens to be not in our hands. Wala ako kasi attestation yung documents ng birth certificate ng aking anak. So what I did, persevere, be patient. So after leaving, I went back. Second time, in the morning, the same day. Again, the captain asked me, where's the attested documents? So again, I went out frustrated. But hindi ko tayo susubo. I went back in the afternoon thinking that the captain will not be there. And the captain was not there. Lo and behold, when I gave the documents, the woman said, just come back tomorrow to see the captain. So the next day, sabi ko, mabigat to. Mukhang hindi makis mo uwi yung aking nag-iisang tagapagmana ng aming lupain sa pasok. Eh ayaw na ayaw po ng nanay niya eh. Ayaw na maliwalay. No? So sabi ko, we have to pray hard. So what I did early in the morning, as usual, I prepared, I dressed good, para katulad nung ginawa ko sa driving license ko. Nag-dress ako ng gusto. At pagkatapos, I went out of the house and immediately ride in the car and prayed. I was just silent and asking Lord, I submit this to you, it's your will, let your will be done. But you promise that whatever I desire, as I delight myself in, you will give it. So, I drove, I asked them to come with me, and before entering the immigration, pinag-pray ko na kagad yung lugar. At bawat tao makarap ko, conquer this guy. In Jesus' name. So lahat ko pinag-pray ko. Pati yung tao na sa harapan ko nung binasa ko na yung documents. In Jesus' name, Lord. Hindi niya hanapin yun. Okay. Pero tinignan. Tinignan. So what I did, yung birth certificate, it happens to be nothing, no attestation, but the documents about diplomas, documentation, pinagsama ko ngayon. Yeah. So when I presented it, ang tinignan niya, yun sa diploma. At tinignan niya na mayroong stamp. Okay? Seriousness. Wow, sabi ko. Iba talaga ang Panginoon. At talaga naman, nakalusot na ako ba't. Pero I was really in that time struggling. Simple as this, but it needs to test you, it needs so that you can, it is needed to exercise your faith at times. Di ba? Kinakailangan, bigyan ka ng Panginoon ng ganyan, para na sa ganun, huwag tutulog-tulog yung pananampalataya natin eh. Kailangan kasi ng exercise. Kaya tuloy, sabi nga nung iba eh, kung pwede nga lang sana, tinitimbang ng kilo, yung taba eh. Marami na sana akong na-donate.
dahil kulang sa exercise. Minsan sa pananampalataya mga kapatid, we need these things. But I'm always grateful. Honestly, I'm encouraged by people in our church. In spite of their struggles in life, physically, with their health, they keep on trusting the Lord. May kapatid dito mga kapatid tayo who went through several operations. And yet, you won't see any regret, any fear. You can only see the courage. Nandun pa rin yung ngiti at yung tiwala sa Diyos. I'm always encouraged by that. At nakakatuwa, even yung kanyang sitwasyon, ginagamit ng Lord so that others will be encouraged too. Kaya meron tayong kapatid na recently, pumunta ng Tawang Hospital because it was found out na meron siyang cancer. Then, but these members of our, who happens to be sick and still recovering, help that person. Can you imagine? Why? Because whenever we are in difficult situations and we trust the Lord, God can still use us as a blessing to other people. Amen po ba? Walang sayang sa karanasan natin. God will use that to bless other people too. This is our journey. He promised, God never promised an easy journey. But He promised that He will be with us to make our journey worthwhile. Amen po ba? Amen. Hindi sinabi ng Panginoon magiging madali yung paglakad mo bilang Kristiyano. Pero sabi ng Panginoon, sasamahan kita. In fact, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And your journey will be worthwhile. Because even your destination is great and outstanding. Ladies and gentlemen, people who have overcome or have risen above the level of mediocrity are people who are fearless because of their faith in God. And you look at your neighbor again and say, kumusta na yung pananampalataya mo kapatid? How's your faith? How's your faith? Tell me. And lastly, people who live above the levels of mediocrity has learned to forsake in order to follow God. Has learned to forsake in order to follow God. Okay, these are the last point. Now, so after the report, what happened is that in chapter 14, we'll find out, ano po? That the people, the whole nation of Israel, was influenced. Kasi, mga kapatid, etong problema. Rebellion is always contagious. Discontentment is always contagious. So these 10, yung 10, when they made the report, sabi ni Joseph Caleb, hindi, kaya natin yan. But dahil doon sa takot nila, wala na yung kanilang tingin sa Diyos, they thought of going back to Egypt, and killing Moses. Verse 2 and 3 of chapter 14 will tell you this. Sabi dyan, all the Israelites grumbled against Moses and Aaron, and the whole assembly said to them, if only we had died in Egypt or in this desert, why is the Lord bringing us to this land only to let us fall by the sword? Or our wives and children will be taken as plunder. Wouldn't it be better for us to go back to Egypt? Ladies and gentlemen, God saved the nation of Israel from Egypt. Inilabas sila sa Egypto. Alipin mo sila itong mga kapatid. What a refreshing situation for them. Yung maging malaya ka, wala kayong, hindi kayo nasabot. Di ba? And here comes the situation, pinalaya na sila, dadalhin sa lupang pangako, but when they were confronted with difficulty, with an obstacle of facing the giant, ang sabi nila, we rather go back to Egypt and die there rather than bring our family and be taken as a plunder of those nations. Alam niyo, natutunan po dati dito mga kapatid. Yes, you can be saved from Egypt, but Egypt must be removed from you. You have been removed by God from Egypt. It is a symbol of Satan's kingdom. But Egypt must be removed from Meninas. Napalaya na po sila sa Ehipto eh. Pero yung kanilang buhay, yung kanilang kaisipan, yung kanilang pananaw, eh pananaw sa Ehipto pa rin po. Makamundo pa rin, walang tiwala sa Diyos. Kaya sabi na, let's go back to Egypt. May mga tao, mga kapatid, pag nasanay sa kasalanan, they rather stay in sin than to be free. Alam niyo ba doon? Sa Pilipinas, meron yan. Go to those places where vices and sins prevails. And once you start initiating to change, magbubuwis ka ng buhay. Because they got used to those sins and those vices that they don't want anyone to interfere with their lives. Eh, yun ang problema mga kapatid. May mga taong nasasanay sa lumang buhay. Again, this is a picture of a nation God delivering from the nation of Egypt, from Egypt, and give them the promised land. Pero what they were asking is that, let's go back to Egypt. Gusto nilang balikan yung dati nilang buhay. Kaya naman, what happened? What happened is that those 10, together with their families and tribes, were destroyed by God. They were not able to rise above the level of mediocrity. They were contented and living a life that slave and slave by sin. Minsan mga kapatid, God would like us to experience great things. Naniniwala ko ba kayo? Amen po ba? Gusto ng Panginoon makaranas tayo ng mga dakilang bagay. Ipaparanas sa atin ng Panginoon yan. But God, in doing that, kailangan meron muna siyang alisin at baguhin sa buhay natin. He's going to transform us. May mga old ways tayo na nakagawian na kinakailang alisin para maranasan natin yun. Because for me, it is not a question whether God blesses people. It's already proven. Because God is good. Amen po ba? It is a question whether we are ready to receive the goodness of God. Handa ba tayong tumanggap ng pagpapala ng Diyos? Yun po ang question eh. Because I cannot find in the scripture any great move of God without asking His people to consecrate their lives. Joshua chapter 3, I think Joshua chapter 3 verse 5. Nung papasukin na nila yung lupa pangako, mga kapatid, kasi 40 years pa eh, dahil sa katigasan ng gulubat, sabi ng Diyos sa kanila, consecrate your lives today because tomorrow, I'll give you the promised land. Alam niyo yung ibig sabihin nun? Ihanda niyo yung mga sarili ninyo, maglinis kayo. If you want to receive the blessing and the promised land, you have to prepare yourself. Sometimes blessings are hindered because we are not prepared to receive it. Because there's something in our lives that must be first removed. Nang sa ganun, makadaloy yung pagpapala ng Diyos. Amen po ba? What are those old ways? Mga lumang kaisipan, lumang kasanayan. Diba? As I always say this, kahit napukristyano na tayo mga kapatid, meron pa tayong mga kasanayan na dapat na binabago at pagpabago sa Panginoon. May mga Kristiyano, napakadali pa rin na magbitaw ng salita. So irresponsible about their comments. At yung kalamay, napaka-critical. Instead of praising the person, what is coming out are more of criticisms. Again, I'm not talking about those good and positive criticisms. Sometimes, the thoughts of being envy are still prevailing. Nag-post lang ng konti something sa Facebook na, uy, may kasiyahan sila. Ba't wala ako dyan? Ba't wala ako dyan? Hindi mo kasama dyan. James says, be careful. Bakit pa kayo nag-aaway-away? Hindi ba dahil merong desire sa loob ninyo na naglalaban at pilit na kumukontrol sa inyo? Minsan, may ganun po mga kapatid. And sometimes, ang daling mamuna na ibang tao, tumingin sa ibang tao.
Pakitignan na mas may katabi mo para sabi, hindi ikaw yung kapatid.
Maraming tao na, ang bilis tumuna. Ang bad news, ulitin ko lang po, ang Pilipino number one po dyan. Oh? Tanoy niyo mga Amerikano, bakit napaka masyadong particular kayo? Sa mga damit, sa itsura, di ba? And we criticize people. Sometimes, it's easy for us to dwell on those things. So irresponsible. We exercise our freedom so much, becoming a